Hello and welcome to the City Newsroom from our studios at number 5 Ola Hansen Lane at Tesano. My name is Michael Ogbodu. Coming up, people from all walks of life attend former football star Christian Achiu's 1 week observation following his tragic death in Turkey. Funeral dates announced.
The funeral will be held at the forecourt of the State House. The forecourt of the State House on the 17th of March 2023.
We'll bring you a story on how damaged traffic lights in Accra pose danger and inconvenience to road users.
They should have an indicator on every traffic light so that when the indicator can signal them or wherever they are, then they will come and work on it.
And later, cocoa farmers call for higher remuneration to attract more growers.
Cheating up on the farmers, we are not giving them the respect. All the time, the farmers are pending debts over them because the money is not enough. Even to take up the expenses which the farmer may just use on labor courses in the farm, he runs a loss.
Citi FM and Citi TV's 2023 Heritage Caravan kicks off its 7-day fun-filled tour of 14 regions of the country.
Oh my God!
She's panting like... How did it go down there?
It was fun. It was a nice experience. Working on my cardio level. My heart's rate. My heart is really pumping right now. It was great.
Thank you for tuning in. Let's bring you our first story now, as high-powered delegations from several quarters were present at the Adjengano AstroTurf earlier on Saturday for the one-week observation of the late Christian Achiu. Officials from Ghana Sports Ministry, Ghana Football Association, religious and traditional circles headlined the event for the former Black Stars player who passed away under excruciating circumstances. City Sports' Yawe J. Minta was at the Adjengano AstroTurf and came through with this report.
Christian Achiu's lifeless body was pulled from a rubble of a collapsed building after two earthquakes hit Turkey and Syria in the wee hours of Monday, February 6. The long wait on news of his whereabouts in the immediate aftermath Worldwide Miracle Outreach Church, Dr. Lawrence Tete. In his speech that opened the program, Dr. Tete gave an uplifting message to the family of the former Newcastle United player.
Than to let him become missing, like for instance, what we are experiencing with Castro. Number two, it's better that God cut everything short and call Achiu home than for him to have been paralyzed for the rest of his life. Number three, it's better that God in his own wisdom decided to take him away now. So if there was any mistake and embarrassment he was going to bring to the family, God cut it short. And number four, for all you know, Achiu was sacrificed to your family.
Sports Minister Mustafa Yusuf led dignitaries from the sports fraternity to grace the event. The Ghana Football Association was heavily represented by President Keto Kweku, General Secretary Prosper Harrison-Addo, Head of Communications Henry Asante Chum, and Executive Council members of the association Sami Enim Addo and Nana Odru Safo. Lead men of the past regime of the association in former President Kwesi Nyantechi and former Vice President George Frie were present to pay their respect to the man who starred during their time in charge of the Black Stars. Honorable Yusuf highlighted the role the government has played since news broke of Achiu's disappearance in the wake of the natural disaster that has claimed over 50,000 lives.
The President of the Republic instructed the Ghana ambassador to Turkey to liaise with the authority, the Turkish authority, to find our brother alive. He issued a statement, a public statement, calling on all Ghanaians to pray for him. But unfortunately, we could not find our brother alive. But notwithstanding that, the president and the government ensured that we brought the body back home, and we gave a very beautiful reception by the vice president receiving the body at the airport. Now, the 1 week, government have taken all the costs of the 1 week in, to assist the family. And the funeral itself is going to be a state. Way and manner Mr. Achun passed on is something that is devastating to everyone. And that is the only time we should all come together as a country to give our brother, our son, a befitting funeral. So we wish the football family and the immediate Achun family our condolence on behalf of the government and the president of the republic.
CEO of Brekum Chelsea, NGFA Executive Council member Nana Odru Safo talked up the impressive turnout at the event.
My observation so far is the whole program have beaten my expectation. I knew people would come. Even people I'm expecting to see here that I'm not seeing, I know they will come. But the Ghanaians have shown so much love that you can see that we prepared for 7,500 people and maybe just a little, but now we have almost about 2,000-3,000. It is fine.
New Patriotic Party presidential candidate Alan Chiremanting signed the book of condolence after he attended the event to empathize with the family and spoke on Achu's commitment to the national cause.
Of all of Ghana's commitment to memorizing. We all know that he showed
and that's a very beautiful
commitment
cultural display
to the cause of our country.
Cultural heritage.
And in doing so,
our very own Langabe.
Discipline, and he was kind-hearted. And as a national celebrity, this is the kind of disposition and comportment that I hope that all those who are privileged and honored enough to be in such positions to learn from Christian Achu's life. You can see the outpouring of love, not only in Ghana, but all over the world following his demise. This is a real testament to the kind of person that he was. And we would also like to sympathize with his family, his wife, the children, and the larger extended family.
The cadet corps from Achu's alma mater, TIMS at Portin, made a presentation to the grieving family, while Kitty and Bobobo groups sang songs. All activities at the ground was delivered in a measured tone. However, the controlled ambience turned up several notches when several Black Stars players thronged the AstroTurf, sparking a mad rush to get glimpses of legendary players like Asamoah Gyan, John Paintle, Stephen Appiah, John Mason, Richard Kingston, Prince Tego, and Emmanuel Ajiman Bedu. Despite the chaotic scenes, the sudden loss of their mates was not lost on his teammates. Ajiman Bedu played at 3 AFCON tournaments with the late Christian Achu and was one of the close teammates of the demised winger, who he described as a blessing for Ghana.
Yeah, what I can say is he was a blessing for the nation. We all saw what he did for the nation, on the field, out of the field. His philanthropic work he has been doing and the kind of games he has really helped us in 2015, especially the African Cup of Nations, that we came second. He was very instrumental in that African Cup of Nations. And even what is going on here right now has to show us that he was a great personality for the country. We have lost a great hero.
The moment of truth arrived once the pandemonium died out. and the date to observe the funeral rites for the late Achu was announced.
On behalf of Abusiapeni and the family of the late Christian Achu Trasam, ladies and gentlemen, the funeral will be held at the forecourt of the State House, the forecourt of the State House, on the 17th of March, 2023. On the 17th of March, 2023. At the forecourt of the State House, the funeral rite of the late Christian Achu Trasam will be held.
In an exclusive chat, spokesperson of the Achu family, Richard Eni, stated the date was fixed with Ghana President Nana Akufo-Addo's presence at the event in mind.
I said some time back that we're all looking for dates that will be convenient for all the stakeholders, i.e. the state, the Ghana Football Association, and the family. So upon careful deliberation, we agreed that 17th would be okay for all of us. So the day 17th was chosen.
Odro Safo, who was privy to the meeting between President Akufo-Addo and Christian Achu's family, on the other hand, was quite emphatic on the reason behind the choice of date for the funeral.
We are doing the funeral on the 17th because the president won't be part of it. As I speak to you, we fix the date and we send it to him for him to okay it. He said he wants to be part of the funeral, nothing more, nothing else.
Just as the program started with a strong message from Dr. Lawrence Tete, the renowned preacher touched on a pointed note in a speech that calls for deep reflection as Ghana continues to mourn the passing of an individual with a big heart.
It took 45 seconds before Reddit for him to lose his life, for him to make his children fatherless, and for him to make his wife a widower, and to make his family members mourners. Live your life well, so when you die, you will have a life.
Family, friends, football stakeholders, ex-teammates, statesmen came from far and near to pay their the late Christian Achu on the 1 week observation of his passing. The main funeral rites will take place at the forecourt of the State House on March 17th, and that is when we will say the final goodbye to the late Christian Achu. Reporting from the Ajegano AstroTurf for City Newsroom, my name is Yao AJ Minta.
Let's bring you more stories now, and the current state of some traffic lights in the Greater Accra region poses a threat to both drivers and pedestrians. Statistics from the National Road Safety Authority shows that 2,171 people died to road crashes between January and November 2022. City News checks with some communities revealed many of the traffic lights have been damaged. There is more in the following report.
Today, we explore obstacles and dangers on the roads that can harm and endanger lives. One of such obstacles is damaged traffic lights. Primarily, traffic lights allow for the free movement of vehicles in the right direction. A faulty traffic light causes congestion and renders the lives of commuters unsafe. City News visited some selected spots to ascertain the state of the traffic lights. The first point of call was the Galilee Junction on the Amanfrum-Kaswa Highway. Residents and commuters say the traffic light has been damaged for over 3 years without any attempts by authorities to fix it.
For this traffic light, I think it has been here for, if I'm not lying, it might be 4 or 5 years now that it has not been working. Negatively, yeah, it is affecting the life of people here because it helps us cross the road. We all know the sequence, how the traffic light works. So as it's not working, it's affecting the people, crossing the road, because it really helps us to cross the road. Accidentally, it has happened many times. And then, where it is placed, I mean where the traffic light is placed, is somehow closer to the bus stop where the cars are parked. And for that matter, I don't think where it is placed is appropriate. It rather should go back a bit from the where the cars or the truck drivers used to park, so that those people also that cross the road, it can be easy for them to grow, because since it is closer to where the cars are parked, it's not appropriate. So from my observation, I think it should go back a little bit like that. First of all, I think this should be a wake-up call for those who fix the traffic lights on our roads. They should have an indicator on every traffic light, so that when the traffic is faulty, the indicator can signal them or wherever they are, that they will come and work on it.
The traffic light over here is about more than 3 years now. This traffic light spoil, nobody, any top officials to come and assist us. Every day, every present day, the accident will happen for here. So we are appealing the top officials to come to do the traffic light for us.
Yeah, there we are saying a high pan, especially say we be cross. So next, as a driver, we the mechanics who stop as a zebra brazner one was who stop what different driver no bano. Be out to be ferry, go so the about traffic no more. A high pan in the assembly for say, on by the idea we answer crime, but yet here we are more than 5 years. The way the anywhere more than 5 years in the high one. And this is a did December for by ya, sir.
The traffic light situation at Latibio Koshi was not so different. It was evident that the pillars holding the traffic light had been removed after it was damaged, and this has worsened the flow of traffic on the stretch. Commuters and residents here also share their thoughts with City News.
For how long have you noticed that the traffic light has not been functioning and it has been taken out?
It has been, I think, 3 years now. Yeah, since I started passing here.
Today, we explore obstacles and dangers on the roads that can harm and endanger lives. One of such obstacles...
As a zebra brazner, one was a stop. Different driver now, Bano. Be out to be ferry. Go so the about traffic no more. A high pan in the assembly for say. On by the idea we answer crime, but yet here we are more than 5 years. The way the anywhere more than 5 years. In the high one, in this year, did December for by ya, sir, car, a bonk of one crumble, a super track.
The traffic light situation at Latibio Koshi was not so different. It was evident that the pillars holding the traffic light had been removed after it was damaged, and this has worsened the flow of traffic on the stretch. Commuters and residents here also share their thoughts with City News.
For how long have you been
now? Since I started passing here, 3 years, if I can say, yes, 3 years. It's causing a lot of problems, because at times, if you get here and there's no police people standing here, you see people have been forcing to find their way, and you know, it can cause an accident. So if government can do something about it, it's going to help a lot. I think they have a whole ministry or an agency or whatever which is under government, which is responsible for traffic lights. They are sitting at the office. This work, they are not supposed to sit at the office. They are supposed to come out and see whether traffic lights are working, everything is going on well. But, you know, this is the kind of country we are living in.
More than 8 to 10 years now, they come and remove the traffic light go, but it didn't break it again.
They give us traffic, a lot of traffic when we are coming. Very difficult traffic here.
City News followed up to Teshi Laskala Junction. According to a resident who spoke on condition of anonymity, the faulty traffic light on that stretch contributes to the road crashes on that stretch.
This Laskala, let's say police station, Laskala police station, and it's been has really caused traffic here, accidents, a whole lot. That's what we have been facing here. We would like if the government can do, is it government per se, or if there can be something that it will be done to it, we'll be okay with it, because it really, really causes accidents over here. Not only what happened this afternoon, but it has been causing accidents.
This is a traffic light cable, the only indicator that tells that there used to be a traffic light pole on this particular point. Residents and commuters that use this side of the road are saying that the absence of the traffic light is over 5 years. They are appealing to the relevant authorities to come salvage the situation. For City News, I am Emmanuel Opon.
The changing crime dynamics requires that the police use advanced methods and techniques in combating attempts by criminal elements to create disorder. A recent wave of broad day robberies, which involved the use of motorbikes by criminal gangs, claimed lives and maimed victims in parts of the country. An initiative by the police administration in the deployment of policemen on motorbikes to counter this crime trend is receiving commendation, and the public want it sustained. City News' Ashanti regional correspondent Hafiz Tijani has more in the following report.
Speaking randomly to people you meet on the streets could lead you to a victim who has a crime story to share.
Yeah, that was Saturday. Now I call Ahojo. My phone 12 floors. It was empty. Dark one. Where is the old way? You know, Ahojo. No. My call was I was phone. No, a cigarette I can see him. So we try to say be a matrix phone. Seconds now, we do find my iPhone. At once now, they say, you be a yeah, you see. That time, no, then the police need be a benwa. I think say be a go beat me a yeah. I go me a my be a mess. I come a phone.
Just as police officers work to improve security and address crimes, criminals continue to adopt new methods to outsmart. Metropolis and parts of the Ashanti region, vehicular congestion makes it difficult to maneuver through easily, especially during rush hours. The use of motorbikes to perpetrate crimes has become common. News about such incidents dominated media headlines in recent years, and the suspects will always have their way after the crime. The deployment of police officers on motorbikes in major communities and commercial areas is gradually addressing this crime trend, according to some members of the public.
First, no, we have been crying on mobility meeting motors, no, she will be phone. Now, we, what I say, they say, there, Sandy Manning, I won't say, then who will be now, you and Tibby crowd to be. That is a first, no.
Obi can bag a cry, but who not obey a shim, and I'm crying, I'll be no be a shim. I know mom use moto no. Mom use moto. No am tutu bon na bone wo mo tim. Kita bag na na mko. Omo timi ehu omko omo timi.
Ah, onye bone. Enti ya high class charge station ya we. Boys be the moto. Bejina Haji sika obi antimi no man challenge nti so amone nam na se saade na no moye dia memo de nkeboa na de make a faka kra me make se bia emwa ene se obeshia driver ni na mtt duvoa adwuma no mum no no mum age ye ene de emwa
road man no man in fact ye eboa se achi ti wo de car kwa na ma
Yeah, that time is wrong. First, then I pa. In India, what for? Be a police. There might be a crack car going to go and in a hope for ma police forum.
These police officers are also stationed at major intersections to enforce road traffic regulations and also track down criminals. Our cameras captured a traffic offender who was given a hot chase and arrested by these officers on motorbikes. In the Ashanti region, the deployment of motorbikes is making a positive impact on crime-fighting efforts by the police. Criminologist and lecturer with the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, Dr. Jones Opokuwari, says the initiative is a laudable one.
If you look at the configuration of our streets, I've always said that this country, it is very difficult for us to do a hot chase or hot pursuit because of the configuration of our streets. Okay, so motorbikes are much easier to use. So sometimes I don't understand why we keep on buying cars for the police. We should deploy more of, you know, the motorbikes, those means of transport that are very easy to meander through our congested streets, so that we can pursue some of these criminals when they happen. Because if you have observed, most of the robberies that happen on the street over the period, they use motorbikes. Why do they use motorbikes and not cars? They use motorbikes because they know that by the configuration of our streets, the streets are very easier to navigate, you know, and to flee from the crime scene with motorbikes than cars. That is why you don't see these robbers going for robberies, these cars, especially on the street. So if the police wants to mind them, it is better for them to also use accoutrements that are comparable to what the criminals are using. So it is very, very good, very important that we continue to provide the police with these kind of logistics so that they can match the criminals with for. So for me, it is a very good initiative. Let's continue to sustain it.
Dr. Opokuwari, however, appeals to the public to support the police to fight crime.
You know, we are supposed to act as informants. We are supposed to give police a lot of information. But when it comes to issues of visibility, you know, there are logistical challenges. Community members who can assist the police. Okay, look, we can buy, if we can even buy one or two for them, let's do it. Okay, to support especially the local communities. So because, for instance, you see that every community, there is some form of a divisional police office or maybe police command. You know, if you can buy one or two motorbikes for them, you can give it to them. They branded the police, and then at least they use it to patrol, you know, the community. Once the criminals get to know that the police are there, they are right with us in the community, I'm telling you, they will not dare operate. Okay, even if they try, they know that their success rate is very limited.
Citi News contacted victims of crimes who were saved by these men on motorbikes, although the victims would not speak even under anonymity.
The presence of police officers on motorbikes at major intersections and communities within the Ashanti region for members of the general public is a laudable initiative, but they are calling on the police administration to sustain this initiative. Hafiz Tijani, Citi News, Ashanti region.
Just to watch in the Citi Newsroom on Citi TV, still to come. Cocoa farmers call for higher remuneration to help attract more growers. We'll bring you the details shortly. Please stay with us. Thank you.
Plus is a fully skimmed evaporated milk. Creamy Plus is available in a shop near you.
This message has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Welcome to Jamila Home, a signature business that houses the most luxurious antique and contemporary furniture. We stock presidential, royal, ministerial, and executive furniture. Just the amazing Windsor chairs with one of the largest choices of genuine Regency and Victorian dining furniture, which once stood for England's finest craftsmanship. Renowned across the world for its luxurious and detailed features, alongside a brilliant blend of Italian contemporary Versace royal set in absolute elegance. Visit our website www.jamilahome.com. Contact us via phone call and WhatsApp on 0302-437-228 and 0205-555-525. We are located at 13 Westland Boulevard, Accra. Jamila Home, your first and best furniture showroom in Ghana and the world.
Yeah, welcome back to the Citi Newsroom. Let's bring you more stories now. The future of Ghana's cocoa industry seems to be under threat as low incomes push to ventures. According to research by Oxfam, the living standards of cocoa farmers in the country keeps declining, with over 90% living in poverty. The government is rejecting to export cocoa $1 billion for the country in 2025. But with the current crop of farmers opting out, the reluctance of the youth to get into the business and production already declining, will government be able to meet its target? Nashika Caesar has the rest of the story.
Cocoa production has been the backbone of the Ghanaian economy for several decades now, with the commodity accounting for about 30% of the country's total foreign exchange earnings. In 2022, cocoa in Ghana was forecast to contribute 3.41 billion Ghana cedis to the country's gross domestic product, GDP. The golden pod, as it is sometimes called, is also expected to account for over 4 billion of GDP by 2025. Despite the enormous contribution of the golden pod to the economy, the farmers who cultivate the cash crop are one of the poorest in the country. COVID-19 is a head of research at Oxfam, and he says research they conducted in 2022 shows that over 90% of cocoa farmers in the country live below the poverty line.
The findings were really quite sobering. 90% of farmers told us that they were today worse off than they were 3 years ago, considering their incomes. We found a significant decline in production by cocoa farmers over the past three harvesting seasons, and also just an explosion in costs of production across cocoa communities.
Currently, cocoa farmers in Ghana receive 800 cedis for a bag of cocoa, a price they lament is woefully inadequate considering the hard work and high cost of production involved in cocoa culture.
People in Ghana is cocoa farmers. And I may say, let me talk here. When today farmers just unite and they amplify their voice that they are going to strike, I think all the nation is going to shut down, because everybody eats in the morning and we drink agriculture, we eat agriculture. And how much more we are just cheating up on the farmers and we are not giving them the respect. All the time the farmers have pending debts over them because the money is not enough even to take up the expenses which the farmer may just use on labor courses in the farm. He runs a loss because of the price is very low.
How much is the price of cocoa now, like the sack, and as compared to maybe 2-3 years ago, and then also in comparison to the prices from Ivory Coast, you know, is Ghana better off?
The current price of a bag of cocoa, that is just 2.5 kilograms, is at 800 cedis. 800 cedis. Before, at the current inflation and economic issues, to the current labor intensive and the production cost, we are not making profit, especially those who have smaller farm sizes.
Cocoa production is a very tedious work, and sometimes you don't get money to provide the necessary chemicals for the insects that comes into your farm. Sometimes we get them, but sometimes we don't get them. And because the money is not enough to purchase all these chemicals, we run at a loss. The government didn't consider the way farmers are suffering and assist them. Very soon they will stop.
UV19 also said chocolatiers or international corporations which buy the cocoa have failed to improve the livelihoods of farmers.
When we visited communities, you oftentimes had 3, 4, 5 companies doing their own little projects in a community rather than working together and really creating synergies across. The second one is really one of missing investment. Companies have high ambitions when it comes to raising the incomes of farmers, but they really have not invested sufficient resources into their programs in order to achieve those. We sometimes came across communities or company agents that were responsible for 50 communities, and of course that level of engagement is not sufficient.
You see a lot of them quitting farming and then venturing into these illegal mining galamsey. You see a lot of them selling off their farms and all that to these illegal miners. Do you think that's a threat to the cocoa industry in Ghana generally?
Oh, absolutely it is. And I think cocoa and chocolate companies are recognizing that. I think that's part of the reason why the issue of higher farm incomes has really risen up in the agenda of these companies. Again, the challenge is that the recognition is there, but the investment currently still isn't.
The farmers also accused the chocolatiers of exploitation.
So the government alone cannot decide. The government tells you what he have is what he has to give. But the international, the LBCs rather, are gaining from the farmers.
This is LBCs.
That's the Purchasing Limited. That's the Yaya Global and Co. The PBC and Co. You know, they decide to come out with the price they want. And when they bring, whether it's good for the farmer or not, in terms of benchmark pricing, we need to get a cocoa board, the interceder to be on behalf and to get a chief farmer to just negotiate with the farmer that how should we make this deal. But later you just hear they said cocoa price have been increased whilst the farmer is not involved.
Look at international outside the private companies that buy the cocoa and process it. They are making enough, but the farmer is still poor. Yes, at a disadvantage of farmer.
The low numbers involved is a threat to the future of Ghana's cocoa industry as youth and cocoa growing communities shy away from growing the cash crop.
Okay, we went for a cocoa price at McDick Royal Hotel at Kufodia, and we made the pricing to 1,000, but later because of the inflations that have been hitting the country, they just alleviated it to 800 Ghana cedis. And I may say cocoa crop is the most export commodity in Ghana. Timbers and gold are there, but that is the one that I may say is a political tree. And whenever they want to make an increment of cocoa, it's just a year of election.
The cocoa farmers say the only way to really help improve their life and secure the future of the Ghanaian economy is by increasing.
The best thing that I think we can do is just to buy it at the right prices, that it will help the farmer to sustain the business. Because if we don't do that, then we fear for the near future.
Finding out that the price of cocoa, like a bag, is now going for 800 Ghana cedis, which you say is not enough. How much will be enough for you?
If they upgrade it to 1,002, it will be okay for us.
Now the cocoa farmers are demanding that as a matter of urgency, government reprices the price of cocoa from the current 800,000 cedis to at least 1,500 cedis. Reporting for City News, my name is Nashika Caesar.
Ghana has over the years produced scholars who have researched into the use of plants and natural products for the treatment of various ailments, but stakeholders are yet to properly take advantage of it in addressing the country's health challenges. It is in line with this that a professor of pharmaceutical microbiology and natural products at KNUST, Professor Christian Ajayi, is calling on policymakers to embrace and explore the use of plants and other natural products in the treatment of non-curable infectious diseases. He is urging relevant authorities to intensify the unrestrained use of drugs, both natural products or orthodox. Citi News' Middle Belt for the Bureau Chief for the Middle Belt, Edward Opomafo, reports.
In Ghana, many people seem to have much confidence in orthodox medicines as against plants or natural products. Despite this trust in orthodox drugs, many non-curable infectious diseases still exist, as they are unable to treat them. Also, there are instances where germs such as bacteria and fungi develop the ability to defeat the drugs designed to kill them, which researchers term as antimicrobial resistance. While researchers across the world are struggling to find an antidote to this, a renowned Ghanaian scholar, Professor Christian Ajayi, says plants and other natural products could be the game changer if policymakers embrace it.
Plants and other natural products do offer some hope in reducing antimicrobial resistance as well as non-curable infectious diseases. They must therefore be embraced and further explored if we desire to win this battle. However, we must be on the side of caution and also intensify public education to curb the unrestrained use of drugs, be it natural products or orthodox, in the management of infections, since we do not know the dangers associated with this chemotherapeutic use.
Professor Christian Ajayi, who is also the provost of College Professorial inaugural lecture, where he highlighted some major findings in his researches that stakeholders can take advantage of. He's thus also advocating for the country to have a well-defined policy direction and intensify the antimicrobial stewardship agenda. In this regard, he's urging regulatory bodies to intensify surveillance to ensure antimicrobial products on the market are of the required standard and are properly handled, prescribed, and used by all relevant stakeholders.
Also, I strongly believe Ghana needs to have a well-defined policy direction and intensify the antimicrobial stewardship agenda. Furthermore, regulatory bodies must intensify surveillance to ensure that antimicrobial products on the market are of the required standard and are properly handled, prescribed, and used by all relevant stakeholders, including Food and Drug Authority Ghana, Pharmacy Council, pharmaceutical manufacturers and importers, distributors, clinicians, prescribers, pharmacists, technicians, pharmacists, etc.
Professor Christian Ajayi also wants policies to be formulated to incorporate some standardized herbal creams and ointments to be prescribed at health facilities.
Plant and plant products or phytochemicals have been ordained for healing since creation. Their rational application can be key in the management of man's infirmities. Plants therefore hold a place in our fight against infections and antimicrobial resistance limits. Therefore, I call on individuals, researchers, healthcare regulators, health professionals, and policymakers engaged in this fight to have a strategic look at the role of herbal medicine in healthcare delivery.
You're still watching the Citi Newsroom on Citi TV, still to come. Citi FM and Citi TV. We have more for you shortly. Please stay with us.
Ghana, the land of vast minerals and rich natural resources. Ghana, the country with a fine blend of heterogeneous cultural expressions worth celebrating. The month of March is the Heritage Month on Citi, and we will be celebrating it in grand style with the theme, Make It Ghana. This is the season of all things Ghanaian, and Citi TV and Citi FM will be marking it with a month-long celebration of our heritage with a myriad of exciting activities just for you. We will be bringing you the Heritage Month on Air series with a focus on stories that reflect the diversified culture and music from the 1st to the 31st of March. Watch out for the Heritage Caravan Diaries and Moments as we embark on a journey full of fun, education, information, wonderful memories, and great bonding moments with the Heritage Caravan from the 4th to the 11th of March. To crown the Heritage Month celebration, we will treat ourselves to delectable, authentic Ghanaian cuisine from the northern, middle and southern zones of the country that reflect our true cultural diversity with a back to your village food bazaar from the 25th to the 26th of March 2023. Remember to make it Ghana in this season of the Heritage Month and beyond. The Heritage Month on Citi is powered by Citi TV in partnership with the Ghana Investment Promotion Center, National Film Authority, and Ghana Tourism Authority, with support from Citi FM. And it is sponsored by the National Lotteries Authority.
Yeah, welcome back to the Citi Newsroom. Now, day one of Citi TV's Heritage Caravan has been filled with breathtaking moments after patrons embarked on a thrilling mountain hike to the Amajope Canopy Walk in the Volta region. Patrons of the 2023 edition of the Heritage Caravan, organized by Citi FM and Citi TV on Saturday, March 4, 2023, began the seven-day fun-filled road trip of a lifetime across Ghana. The excited patrons couldn't hide their joy when they shared their experience with Citi News' Fred Duho.
The much-anticipated Citi TV's Heritage Caravan is here, and the day, which is March 4, 2023, is basically here. And as we speak, the vehicles, as of 5 a.m., were all present in the premises of Citi TV at Tesano. And in the premises itself, you would see that the entire place is currently congested because dozens of patrons have arrived and are going through the registration processes, where they are being given some souvenirs from our major sponsors and partners as well, for that matter. So you can see on this particular STC bus that all our sponsors are featured on the bus: Voltaic, Hollard, Mortar, Guinness, Colgate, NLA, Guerl, the European Union in Ghana, the Ghana Tourism Authority, and Ebony Condom. You can see a number of patrons bringing in their buses at this juncture, where even the MD of Citi FMC TV and the marketing manager are also helping.
The best part for me was when my car got here, someone was ready to assist to pack out. I think that's impressive. Citi TV, Charlie, you guys, see first.
We are sponging with our natural extract, so you get samples of the natural extract. And we've added some charcoal and toothbrushes, a mouthwash, and a bar soap, Irish Spring bar soap, and a t-shirt.
That is quite enough to last them for the period, I think.
And more.
And I'm from the UK. I've come from London especially to go on this trip.
So where did you hear this from?
I heard it from a friend. So I do have a friend that I'm traveling with. She's Ghanaian and she lives here. So I did it as a come to see her and also do a road trip together on this amazing experience.
So they've welcomed us. We've gotten a souvenir. So we are just packing up so that we'll get ready to leave.
What are you looking forward to?
Well, a wonderful trip. We were there last year, so we have a fair idea about what to expect. So we are looking forward to a great trip.
So tagging of bags is taking place to load onto the buses, and then we would commence. They've taken their souvenirs from Guel.
Last year I was in bus one, okay, the diplomatic bus. But this year, where the party day today.
Now let me take you to the registration table at this moment, where we have the sale of t-shirts, the Make It Ghana t-shirt. As you may be aware, we have the Make in Ghana for the general public. Registration is taking place. We can see all our clients, and we see the staff of Citi FMC TV are present and also giving off their best.
I'm a fan loving person, mm-hmm, and really looking forward for a great and momentous adventure throughout this country. I mean, heard of a lot of beautiful places that I will have the opportunity to go and see for myself. And sincerely, it's an opportunity of a lifetime.
Six vehicles joining the convoy. So when we are done, they will all get on board the bus where we will set off from Accra after everything. And when we head towards the Volta region, we are going to have the Jama session. So at this point, I want to now take you into the bus.
Oh yes, I've made it. But Sally, it takes some time.
Oh yes. So the people is in your shirt. I'm exhausted as I am. It's quite hectic going down there to the valley, and then the west part of it is climbing up. You can see one of our drivers coming. He's so exhausted and he's taking it slowly. Are you sure you'll be able to drive us again? So, some are still coming, and this is the interesting part of it. Those who have not done exercise in a long while.
We have.
Oh my God.
She's panting like. How did it go down there?
It was fun. It was a nice experience. Working on my cardio level, my heart rate. My heart is really pumping right now. It was great.
It was challenging. Come on. It was challenging, but it was such an adventure and such an experience. You wouldn't even experience it if somebody tells you. You wouldn't even fathom. You would only have to come here to experience it, to understand it. And we got to do that only with Heritage Caravan and, of course, with Colgate. Choose Colgate Natural. Always. You are welcome.
So those were some exciting footages on the Heritage Caravan. Let's go live now to the trip, where my colleague Fred Duho will bring us some live updates. Fred, if you can hear me, where are you guys right now and what is happening where you are?
Michael, we are live from the Royal Senti here in the eastern region of Ghana. We got here some few hours ago from the Volta region after some breathtaking experience at the waterfall. But at this moment, most of the patrons are exhausted and they are currently being treated to some indigenous meal here at the Royal Senti. Then again, the fact that we have Kwampa band giving us some Ghana palm wine music here, soothing one, of course, in the background, that makes it quite interesting where the patrons are eating alongside, enjoying the soothing music from Kwampa. And as we speak, they are waiting patiently to bar or dinner, and then they move in to have a sleep. But I would want to tell you that it's been a very interesting trip so far. Mm. It's been quite an exciting one. The patrons, they've been sharing their experience as you played in the earlier videos. It's been, a trip of a lifetime. And Kwampa's presence here at the Royal Senti at this moment is being made possible. Mm. Kind Ketsi Ebony Condoms, they are sponsoring Kwampa's presence at this particular event or at Royal Senti at the moment. But we can't do all this without mentioning or acknowledging the efforts and the sponsorship from our partners, for that matter, the Ghana Tourism Authority, who has been the backbone of this event from day one.
Okay.
And we have the European Union in Ghana.
All right, we can see you're clearly having a lot of fun there. It's unfortunate that we couldn't join you. Hopefully next year we will join you in all of the fun that you're having there. But, well, if you couldn't make it, you clearly missed out on all that is happening here at the Heritage Caravan. But that will be all for today's edition of the Citi Newsroom here on Citi TV. Our website, citinewsroom.com, has more information on our top stories and more. YouTube for more exclusive video content from Citi TV. You can also watch Citi TV on DSTV channel 363 and on GoTV channel 182. My name is Michael Ogbodu. Thank you for watching. As always, please stay safe.